I surprised him.
It would be a very unwise move to annoy me in my own home. He will behave in my house.
I wouldn't argue. Charlotte begins with her dessert, the West Country favourite, green tea with me. I see what you did there.
Sounds like a bit patchy, don't you? Green tea with me, served with an essential pot of tea.
Well, there's a way that us in Devon serve our cream teas, whether it's jam on cream or cream on jam, so let's see if she gets that right.
Sadly, without a pair of scales, our host has more pressing matters to deal with.
He needs 5 grams of butter, which I know how much that was. Let's go for that.
Yeah, just shove it in, there's only a grand at stake. After kneading her guesstimated dough, she breaks out the old sucky sucky yucky yucky drink.
Just put it into the next plate, and out.
A brush of yolk on the scone, and it's into bake. Now, why would you say a thing like that?
What? I'm really cross now.
Why is that then?
I made a complete disaster. I brought some baking powder in. I'm going to clean down and match.
I love cream cheese. I love cream cheese. I love cream cheese.
Okay, got it. Charlotte eventually finishes her scones, and it's on to the main. Mapping pasties with veg and gravy.
I'm actually frightened of gravy.
It sounds nice. Very sort of Devon, with the pasties and all.
I love gravy, yeah. Yeah, very good. It's all gravy, baby.
Gravy! Gravy!
Gravy! Her West Country pasties, Charlotte prepares potato, swede, onion and nutmeg.
Meat goes always on top of the veg.
She then folds, crimps and sets aside. She'll make her veg and gravy once the guests arrive. Finally, for starter, pass the parcel on a nest of lettuce. What?
Might be more of like those 5-bird roasts, but using little birds. So kind of like a budgie with a sparrow with a wren.
You might be overthinking this one.
Maybe she's taking an iceberg lettuce, dismantled it, put lots of sweets in there, and every time we take a leaf off, we get a little bit of a nibble.
Yeah, well, let's find out.
I put it past the parcel because I couldn't think of anything cleverer to call it.
Oh, I'm disappointed. Her pastry is shaped, ready to be cooked later, and with the party looming, folks turn to Charlotte and Phil.
At the moment, it's just kind of feisty banter between the two of them, but they cope very well with some kind of twist to the darker side.
I just hope it's annoying enough to set Charlotte off to put him in his place.
After finishing her prep, Charlotte is spruced.
Oh, here we go. First time lucky.
And ready to roll for her first proper dinner party. First to arrive is Mr. Alter Ego himself, Phil.
Hello.
Hi, it's me.
Oh, thank you so much.
You look really dapper, actually. I'm loving this look.
And you inspired me.
Next up, the love child of Richard Gere and Robbie Savage, it's Alter David.
Hello.
Gorgeous lady.
Are you all right?
Good, yeah. Really good.
The West Country, even in UK, man.
I
and Hawaiian shirts can't sort out.
Charlotte hasn't surprised me at all. She is a loud, bubbly person.
What should we do when a drunken say?
What was different tonight? I expected a little bit of fraction between her and Phil, and it's just not happened.
It's nice to see the other sides of Charlotte, the kind of warmer side, the gentler side, the good hostess side.
I think the group have taken me exactly for what I am. There's never a hidden agenda.
Top 10 Scottish beers.
Good grief! I do have a reason.